All right, just moments ago, we launched a landmark moment in our history. Joining us live right now is Dr. Ray Smock. He's actually a renowned historian. In fact, he was a historian for the House of Representatives for 11 years. Dr. Smock, thank you so much for joining us. So what were some of your biggest key takeaways from Biden's speech, and how would you compare it to past inaugural speeches?
Well, I could say one thing about it. It was short, and that's good on a cold day. But I think he hit all the things that normally a president hits on these occasions. He talked about the challenges before us, and boy, he certainly laid out some, from global warming to the pandemic to uniting the country and bringing the economy back. Those are huge issues on any president's plate, and he hit those statements. And I like the way he spoke from his heart. He spoke directly to the people. It was not grand, sweeping, elegant talk. It was Joe Biden talking directly to the people, and that's the way I saw it.
Yeah, definitely very genuine. So you've been attending inaugurations all the way back to 1969 when Nixon was inaugurated. You love being a part of history. That's just something you enjoy doing. How are you feeling today with it all being set up virtually?
I'm delighted. I love these events. I've been to so many of them, and they are a very important, a nation has to have its symbols and it has its ceremonies, and they are very important. And today's was very important. I like the way the mall was covered with 200,000 American flags. People couldn't get there to join because of the pandemic. And so it was a small crowd, but the beautiful way in which the mall was decorated was very, very important. And I can remember looking back at other inaugurations, looking back at a sea of maybe a million people, and looking down the mall and seeing flags was equally inspiring. So they are the symbols of us all. And so we were all there in spirit. And I like that part of it very much.
Yeah, definitely a stunning display. So Dr. Smock, since you've been to so many inaugurations, it was pretty cold today, so I'm sure you're glad that you weren't outside. Do you remember any fun stories during past inaugurations and having to stand outside for hours?
Well, you know, the Ronald Reagan has the record for the warmest and one of the coldest, the second coldest. When he was inaugurated, the first time it was 55 degrees and sunny, and it was a very pleasant day on the Capitol grounds. And in 1985, I was supposed to be on as a color commentator on CBS, and lo and behold, it was so cold that they canceled the inauguration. It was 7 degrees outside, and the cameras frosted up. They couldn't do the parade, and they moved the whole inauguration into the Capitol in 1985. But probably the coldest in real terms was 1873, Ulysses S. Grant. They had a big inaugural ball planned in tents in D.C., and it was so cold that all the oysters that they had opened up for people froze in their plates. They had singing canaries, and the poor canaries unfortunately perished in the cold. So that was the coldest. It was zero, and I'd rather have the one. Today was a nice average, a few snowflakes, but in the 40s, you can't hardly beat it. And the sun was shining.
And Dr. Smock, since you've been to so many inaugurations, you know, the absence of Donald Trump there, what are your thoughts on that?
Well, I'm sorry that he didn't follow through with the normal procedure, but that was his choice. And I thought that the way the ceremony went, it was a beautiful ceremony. It would have been a beautiful ceremony had he chosen to come and be part of the peaceful transfer of power. But I don't think that he certainly wasn't mentioned by any of the speakers. And that's unfortunate, but that's the way he decided he wanted it.
All right. Thank you so much, Dr. Smock, for joining us today. And also, you know, President Biden has been a career politician.